Hey, how you doing? Andy with you for another Nail Guitar Skills lesson. Today's topic is chord cutoffs, and I got a great question in the mailbag in relation to chord cutoffs in a Taylor Swift song that I was teaching, and I didn't really go into it in that, because obviously I'm just teaching the song, not digging into the technique. So that's what right now is for, if you have trouble with your chord cutoffs. What is a chord cutoff? Something like this. That sort of thing, cutting off the chord straight after the strum. So, how do you get good at chord cutoffs? Well, what we need to do is we need to take away all this other moving stuff that's going on and focus on the hand that's important. It's this one. This is where the cutoff's going on. And what I find a lot of people have trouble with is making things harder for themselves than they need to be. When I have a student here in the studio, what I always get them to do is really focus on the technique that they're trying to get there and disregard the other hand. So if we're trying to get chord cutoffs with this hand, don't go moving your chords around. You've got more to think about that way. Stay on one chord. So we're going to pick a G chord for this. If you have trouble with your chords, check out the chord lessons that I've got for you. I'll assume that you know your G chord, good common chord. All right, here's what we're going to do. We're going to strum it for a bar, and then we're going to do four chord cutoffs, so on each beat. So it's going to sound like this. That's it. Then we're going to loop that over. Okay, let's have a look at the technique first of all. We need to make sure that our arm isn't moving around too much because we need it to be right here to cut off our chord. So I'm going to zoom in and give you a good look at exactly what I'm doing here. Alright, so that's what it looks like close up. The trick is that we're rotating our hand, just dipping that in. So it's not a case of bringing the hand up and down so much as it is simply bringing that little rotation in there. So strum, and you got that little bit of a twist in your hand anyway as you go to strum. If you're doing strumming like that, you know, it means you're playing a bit stiff anyway. You need to get a bit of that rotation. So all you're doing is coming backwards from that twist. Twist, twist back. So trying it with the strum. Doesn't matter what strumming pattern you do, but I'm going 1, 2, and 3, and 4. Mute, 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 mute. Down, down, up, down, up, down. Once you get comfortable with it, then throw your chord changes in again. You notice once you go through this on the one chord, you realize, of course, why am I throwing all that extra stuff in there, making it hard for yourself? Make learning a new technique easy for yourself. Take this as a bigger lesson than just getting these chord cutoffs. Remember, whenever you learn something new, make it as easy as possible. Take away all the other stuff. Just work on just that technique and then build it up again. So if I then try G for a bar, E, D, try that, G, E minor, D, G, E minor. All right, there you go, that gives you a little bit of a mission, a little bit of a way to put this all into action to get your chord cutoffs going. Trust me, once you're going with it, you'll be super peachy, have no problems at all. All right, check out the freebies that I've got down below for you, including the Nail Guitar VIP and Give Me Drums, free drums, MP3 drum tracks, great for practicing along to for this sort of thing, keeping yourself in time. And check out the other channels that I've got available. I've got the Song Lessons channel and Lead Guitar, yeah, if I can say it properly, Lead Guitar channel as well to help you out with all that sort of thing. All right, catch you for another lesson real soon. Have fun playing your acts. Get those cutoffs going. Check out the Nail Guitar Skills channel to learn more guitar skills. And check out my other channels for heaps of free guitar training videos. If you're on Facebook or Twitter, you can catch me there also.